Hi everyone, this is Jean Hansen, co-founder of the janitorial store and myhousecleaningbiz.com. Today I'm going to talk about a topic that's been in the news and social media a lot lately, and maybe you've participated in some of the discussions, and that topic is sexual harassment in the workplace. Now hopefully you don't have personal experience with it. I know that a lot of us do, but as a business owner, you need to know how to handle this when it comes up in your own business. You need to know how to talk to your employees and how to investigate accusations. So I found a video at Clean Smart University that's a really good starting place to get the discussion going and just to learn for yourself and maybe start a conversation with your employees. So let me switch over. I'm going to play the first part here. There are two types of harassment.
First, let's take a look at the two types of harassment. Those are quid pro quo and hostile work environment. For the record, both are illegal, they are wrong, and they have no place in the business world. In Latin, quid pro quo means this for that. This occurs when employment or employment decisions, promotions, favorable projects, and performance evaluations are based on an employee's acceptance of unwelcome sexual behavior. It can take many forms, and it can be as direct as, if you want this promotion, you'll sleep with me. Or it may seem as innocent as, let's discuss your next project over a glass of wine at my house. The other type of workplace harassment is hostile work environment. This is a work environment that is created by unwelcome sexual behavior or behavior directed at an employee because of that employee's sex. The behavior is so severe and so persistent that it adversely affects the employee's ability to do their job. Again, it can be as obvious as physical touching, hugging, kissing. It can be verbal, including sexual remarks about a person's clothing, their body, requests for dates, conversations of a sexual nature, including jokes. It also includes nonverbal behavior, such as the display of sexually explicit materials in the workplace. Those are the two types of harassment that occur.
Okay, so now that we know the two types, I want to talk a little bit more in depth on the different levels of harassment, and so I'm going to skip ahead a little bit on the video.
Five levels of harassment are level one, sexual remarks, level two, social touching, level three, solicitation, level four, textbook harassment, and level five, assault. Sexual remarks is probably the most common level, and it's often overlooked. It's pretty much exactly what it sounds like. Generalized sexual remarks directed at a target. This level also includes off-color jokes, suggestive remarks, or ogling and staring. Some people are just very free with their hands and with social touching. They're continually touching, always in areas that are socially acceptable. For example, they might usher people through the door with the small of their back, or they might find a reason to brush something off your shoulder. It could be putting your arm around someone, welcoming them to the team. It's all socially acceptable, but it's very irritating and it doesn't need to happen in the workplace. Why do you have to touch somebody? In our culture, basically the only business touching we're allowed or supposed to do is handshakes. Once you get past a handshake, why do you have to put your hand on somebody's shoulder or their back or grab them by the arm? Why do you have to do anything like that in a business environment? The answer is you don't. The third level is about soliciting.
Okay, so those were the first couple levels, and I'm sure that most of us can relate to a lot of this. A lot of it is just verbal. Some of it's a little bit of touching. Maybe you've got someone that is a little bit too touchy-feely, but you put up with it because you don't want to be rude. So these are things that start a good discussion with your employees and especially your supervisors and managers who are probably going to have to deal with this along with you so that you can make some decisions. So I'm going to switch back now for just a moment to show you some more videos that we have available on this topic at the janitorial store and Clean Smart University. So I went up to our search box and just typed in sexual harassment, and I got 95 results. So there are a lot of videos on this topic, so you can learn all about it. There are also Spanish-speaking videos in here. So if you have Spanish-speaking employees, there is videos that you can share with them as well in that sector. So if you want to get access to Clean Smart University, all you have to do is join as a premium member of either the janitorialstore.com harassmentcoaching.com or myhousecleaningbiz.com, and you can get access to all these videos. We've got over 8,000 professional training videos included with your membership. So just visit us at the janitorial store or myhousecleaningbiz.com. If you have any questions, just let me know, and have a great day.